What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another highly combustible reaction. We're jumping into something. The Fallen on D-Day, 9,000 sand drawings. It says about it's, that it's about the landing of Normandy. I'm saying Normandy was in my mind. That's one of the most crazy forms of battle that I've ever kind of seen. Like, heard people talk about just the intensity of it, or people falling all around you. I definitely one that I'm glad damn sure that I wasn't born for 110%. Those were some hard ass individuals setting foot on the beach that day. Hey, it says here in the description, artist Andy Moss and Jamie Wardley organized volunteers to create their art project, The Fallen 9000. On September 21st, 2013. The event, which was part of International Peace Day, was organized to commemorate those Canadian, American, British, and German citizens who lost their lives on D-Day. They gathered on the Arromanches beach in Normandy, France, to stencil images of fallen soldiers in the sand, only to have the tide wash them away at the end of the day. Listen, that's a lot of fallen people. If you want more information, I'll include their website down below. Definitely a lot of people. 9,000 is a lot. We don't really think of it. We look at it, we see a 9 and 3 zeros. But I have a feeling when you see 9,000 stenciled images on a beach, it's gonna be a little bit overwhelming. Let's jump in, let's check it out together. Let's see what we got. If you guys enjoy it, go show Woody Docs some love. We're already subbed up, we've already hit the like button. Let's roll.
It was one of the most decisive moments of the Second World War. 150,000 Allied troops storming the beaches of Normandy. But D-Day, of course, came at a terrible cost.
9,000 fell in the initial fighting, and this weekend they were remembered on one of the French beaches where they died. Joe Inwood was there to see a unique project by artists from Yorkshire honouring the fallen.
Beaches everywhere, reminders of the 9,000 who died on D-Day. This weekend, their sacrifice was remembered by hundreds of volunteers, led by two artists from Bradford.
All around us, there are relics of the Second World War, but the one thing that is missing is the people that actually died. This is the sacrifice and the loss that you have when we have these conflicts.
To represent those sacrifices, 9,000 silhouettes, each one raked by volunteers, including Monica Kershaw from Bradford. She's experienced the cost of war firsthand when her son Christopher was killed in Afghanistan.
It's been very emotional, really emotional day, just watching everybody take part in it, and took the part in myself, and it just really hit home.
Also on the beach this weekend, two men who experienced D-Day itself.
Very nice to meet you. Yeah.
Hey, that's crazy. Like, definitely for those two men. But what an eye-opening experience it would have been for everybody else to look around this beach and see exactly what it would have looked like. Like, here's the reminder. That's, well, I'm telling you, we don't see 9,000 for what 9,000 really is.
Très heureux de vous rencontrer.
George Batts was a British serviceman who helped take the beaches, as Roger LeBlanc watched from the town.
You know, you can talk about 100 dead, 500, 1,000, 2,000, 50,000. And what does it mean? Nothing. Because you can't visualize it.
It's impossible to visualize 100%. Like, we just can't see it.
Parce que c'est là qu'on se rend compte maintenant, avec le recul, le nombre de morts que ça a occasionné.
I don't think anybody who sees it will be under any illusion of what happened on that day.
And so people came not just from France and Britain, but all across Europe, right around the world, to take part in something global, something representing peace, and to create something spectacular.
Every single one of those people who helped Drake, I promise you, it was a whole new outlook, a whole new understanding of some things now. Like just seeing the extreme that it was. That's some kind of things that I don't care what movie it is. No movie out there can actually show you. Or they can show you, but they can't tell you how it felt to be there. They can never give you 100% picture. But damn it, if seeing it like that isn't like a wrecking ball to your heart, seeing 9,000 on a beach is...
We very quietly made a very big statement. And it's there right before you, because that's about 9,000 people. And I was kind of holding it together, and then a plane flew past and did a little flyby, which we didn't know about, and that kind of just broke me.
It's quite emotional because I've done my six soldiers from the Warriors Six on the beach down there, and I've named them all, and I'm just waiting for the water to come and wash them away.
And you know, think of their ages, under 22, 23. They had no life. But let's hope to God it never happens again.
Hey, I will echo his words 110 times, I swear to God. That's what we have to hope, is that people pay attention. Learn about things that happen. Get out there and do your damn research. All of the world's information is right there at our fingertips now. It's a simple Google search of a reputable website to get information these days. That's it. Find out the things that happen. School yourself up so that we can make sure that shit like this never has to occur again.
It mustn't happen again.
And that was the message of this work. 9,000 figures representing 9,000 lives. Fleeting, precious, and as quickly as they'd appeared, lost to the waves. Joe Inwood,
wow.
BBC Look North, Aramanche.
Well, we saw him briefly in that report. Let's talk to Andy Moss now, one of the sand artists behind that D-Day work. Getting something like that right is very difficult. How conscious were you that you had to do that?
We obviously did a lot of preparation, but one thing we couldn't actually anticipate was how many people would turn up on the day. We took coach full of people from Bradford, 30, and then probably another, we could rely on another 10, 20 people to turn up.
But look how many did.
Yeah, well, this is what was so moving about the experience we had there, because people came from all over the world who worked with people from Germany, America, Australia, people from Israel, and for everyone to work together on a piece that looks like it's about a tribute about people that died in war, but the great thing about this piece that we produce, we think, is that it's about peace. And it says it's a very strong statement about peace, because it shows what happens in the absence of peace. And that's why we did it on World Peace Day, the 21st of September, instead of the 6th of June. So that's very important for us.
It's an amazing achievement to pull it off, Andy. And I imagine that the timing must have been crucial to get 9,000 stencils down on the sand before the tide came in. How difficult was that?
The irony is, it's one of the easiest jobs in, practically speaking, I've worked on, because the people came because they showed interest in what we were doing. And that was because the film's great, but it really doesn't speak enough about the emotion of the day for those who were there. And unless you were there, it's hard to explain how special it was for people. And the idea of a group of people who specifically wanted to say something about peace and produce a strong message, coming together and achieving that, it's incredible.
Briefly, anything else in the pipeline for you?
Well, we've drawn attention to the 21st of September as World Peace Day. Obviously, it's been going, I think, since 1999. So next year, I do think we want to do something else.
Andy, lovely to talk to you. Well done. Well done as well.
Thank you.
Absolutely a very cool video. Shout out to anybody that actually jumped on a plane, jumped in a car, walked down to the beach and participated in that. That's freaking awesome. What an overwhelming way to see it. We weren't there. The people that were there just looking at all of the sand etchings, and you can imagine the images that they must have in their heads. God bless them. Like, yeah, definitely a hard one, but one that must never, ever be forgotten for sure. Since we can make sure shit like that never, ever happens again. If you guys enjoyed it, go show Woody Docs some love. Smash the like button if you liked it. The dislike button, but I won't believe you. Check out the other video over here. Until the next one, mildly combustible. You guys be happy, healthy, safe. Love you to the moon and back. Peace.